Hello, friends. Craig Ballard, Raptors Wrap, taking a look at Saturday night's main event. Oh, no. Well, not that Saturday night's main event. That would be awesome. That would be awesome. And if you know, you know. But I'm not talking about that Saturday night's main event. I'm talking about in Raptor land as your Toronto Raptors take their 3-3 record on the road into Indiana to take on the Pacers. Second time this week that we'll see Raptors-Pacers. This game actually kicks off a tough stretch for the Raptors' schedule. 11 of their next 14 games will be on the road. Wow. So it is go time as far as picking things up for the Toronto Raptors. Now, the glass half full for this game, the Raptors did handle the Pacers fairly easily back on Wednesday night. Glass half empty, this is game two of a back-to-back. We know the Raptors traditionally struggle mightily in games, in the second games on back-to-back. 3-13 last season in this scenario, already 0-1 this season in this scenario. And the really odd thing, the Indiana Pacers are the exact opposite. They excel in this scenario, and the Pacers played last night. This is game two of a back-to-back for the Pacers as well. 12-5 in this scenario last season. Wow. And the 1-5 Pacers, their only win this season was their only time they've had game two of a back-to-back. So somehow the Pacers are excelling in this scenario. Now, as far as on the court, we know that Raptor rookie Scotty Barnes getting a lot of love as far as rookies are concerned. Deservedly so, we get it. But as far as rookies to be excited about, the Indiana Pacers cupboard isn't exactly bare. How about Chris Duarte? The Montreal-born Duarte, number 13th overall pick. The Raptors held Duarte to 14 points on Wednesday. And I say held because 14 points is a legitimate contribution, especially from a rookie. But that was Duarte's lowest point output of the season. He's averaging 19 points per game. Been really impressive. Now, if you remember the Craig's key from Wednesday night's game, it's the same as tonight because the issue for the Pacers remains the same, that third quarter. Longtime Pacers coach Rick Carlisle, then longtime Mavs coach Rick Carlisle, back for his second time around with the Pacers, and so far he is struggling to understand his new roster. Every adjustment he and his coaching staff have made at halftime of every game has not been the right one. Pacers averaging being outscored by 10 in the third quarters. So if you're the Toronto Raptors, same thing as we saw the other night. Try to stay competitive. Do whatever you can do, whatever you need to do to stay involved and competitive. You're in the game at halftime because you got to feel good about your chances to take over the game in the third quarter.